what I'm going to do is for the real development, I'm going to connect to another org and sync with that. Okay, before, so let's continue with this and see the structure of a basic LWC component. Okay, so basically the LWC component contains of three parts. One is the HTML, which is the, of course, where you write all your tags and all. And then all the interactivity and the business logic on all the JavaScript methods reside in the JS file. And CSS, of course, is for style. Now, if you see compared to the Aura component, there is no separate helper class over here. Okay. So what is actually the component part in your Aura component is come to your component.html and the JS file. Now, this is typically common for whether you use React or Angular. You generally have an HTML and then you have a JS file. So that's how the LWC model also is following the same structure. Okay. So let's see what it is. So HTML will contain the markup, okay, whatever UI you want to build. JS files will contain the JavaScript logic, your connections to Aura Apex, your variable declarations, all that, okay. And then there are a lot of things like, you know, whether it should be exposed, whether it should be hidden, all things are held within the JS file. And CSS contains the style tag. Now remember one thing, all this markup that you put in HTML should be inside something called as a template stack. Okay, like you had Aura component or Visual Apex page, you have to start and end it with a template. Remember this, all of this has to be within a template tag. So this is a basic thing of a LWC component. Now as we continue, as we'll see, the HTML contains a markup, the JS contains the logic, it also contains the main imports. Okay, now if you want to earlier what you were doing in Lightning component was used to say controller is equal to controller name to get access to the Aura Apex controller. But here what we do is we import like normal React.js or Angular.js, or we are going to import the APIs of Salesforce. So Salesforce exposes now API as imports. Okay, so we're going to import the APIs in our JS. And of course, JS will hold the main class and the methods, all right, the entry point. And also one or a couple of things in the meta XML, you can specify, like say whether it should be available for a component, whether the component should be available for, and so you can make it available whether in the record page, app page or home page. Okay, so that way you specify where you want it to be visible. So we look at all of this in detail. Now the first thing that we will look is we will build a simple home component, and we will try to see the, we'll build our first hello world component and try to invoke it. Okay, and the first thing that we will try to see is how to bind variables. You can create variables in the JS file, transmit them to the UI. So basically if you say @API, it exposes the var to the UI. Okay, the variable name equal to the value. So and to reflect this in the UI, basically now what you're going to do is you're not going to use the V dot convention in double quotes. You're going to directly say equal to curly brace the variable name. Alright, you have Lightning input tag and you will say variable name. So let's go ahead build our first component and see it. Okay,